Want to take another shot, Gunslinger?
Here are a few times I've had to put hecklers in their place.
Most Jewish thing you've ever done.
Most Jewish thing I've ever done. First of all, are you Jewish?
No, I'm not.
No? Then don't ask that question. Most Jewish thing I've ever done. Probably get circumcised, I think. A bris is pretty fucking Jewish. Oh, I got bar mitzvah once. That was super Jewish. It was like, that was like crazy Jewish. Fucking stereotype. What are you Christian?
I'm
what?
Not religious.
Not religious. What were you born into?
Mom's Protestant.
Mom was Protestant. Okay. Is that a form of Christianity?
Subset
of Christianity. So I'm just getting to the answer was yes. Be great. What's the most Christian thing you've ever done?
I actually killed a bunch of people for their faith.
Drove a lot of people out of town and told them it was their fault. That's the most Christian thing I've ever done.
Did you just say the phrase, who cares about gay marriage, let's talk about politics? Do you understand what the fuck? Who cares about gay marriage, let's just talk about the people who are talking about it. Alright, I love that, you know, she approached this thing like I didn't have a fucking plan. This is my favorite thing. Are you the type of person who, while you're in a passenger seat in a car, you just like, drive forward. Just keep driving. Make sure your foot's on the gas. Don't step on the gas when you want to slow down. Put it on the brake. Make sure. I would love to have her on my GPS. It's gonna go, 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 go. When possible, make a U-turn. Go, 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 go. Don't go straight, just move forward and don't change direction. Let me talk about gay marriage now. I'm going to talk about gay marriage and it will get political, I promise you. Because it's not just going to be like, aren't their weddings the best?
What career did your mom want you to have?
What career did my mom want me to have? Oh, that sounded judgy. Probably the one that makes me on television and have a good amount of money. What career did, oh, that's the one I have. What's the one that, what career did your mom, what do you do for a living?
I work for an internet company.
You work for an internet company?
Yeah.
Okay, let me just say this. If you work for a successful internet company, you tell me which the fuck won, okay? You partner with Google. So does everyone, against their will. He was like, no, we were totally okay with it when they took us over. We were totally okay with it. When they came in and they're like, this is ours now. And you're like, okay, do we at least get 20 tickets to a comedy show? He was like, you may have the tickets, but you must go. Here's the fun part. I'm gonna have to Google what the fuck you guys do. What's the name of your company?
Boost Media.
What is it?
Boost Media.
Boost Media. Has anyone ever used that as a verb? Has anyone ever been like, we had to boost media this? They're starting to. Good for you guys. Well, clearly, you're doing well enough to afford a company outing, which is better than a lot of other companies right now, because there are other people who are like, I work for an internet company. They're like, oh yeah, well, I have an email address. So good for you guys, and I know I tease, but I do appreciate that you came here and you shared whatever the fuck you guys do with us. Boost Media, that's not like Boost Mobile, right? Okay, you guys don't sell ghetto cell phones, you don't take advantage of poor people, you know? Or do you in other ways? In your personal life? Oh, fantastic. Like, after the show, that's our next company outing, actually. We're gonna go over to East Bay, we're gonna find some pores. And we are gonna boost our media all over them. That's what we're gonna do.
Do I have a soul? I hope I don't. I truly hope I don't. I hope that redheads don't have souls, because that's one less repercussion if we rise up and kill the rest of you. So, the person who asked that, do you have right here?
No, I just have many friends and past lovers.
Oh, some of your best friends are. You said many friends and past lovers? What the fuck is this, the 18th century? I have taken a lover, he has fire upon his head. Dearest Eleanor, like what the fuck? You fucked a couple redheads, that's how we say it today. I've had many lovers who were red of the hair. Auburn tresses, if you will. None of them had souls. Anyway, so.
So, two things. One is my birthday.
One is your birthday.
Two. So, one.
How the fuck does that have to do with my set?
1.A, take a shirt off.
1.A, take my shirt off. This is. It's your birthday, so I should take my shirt off.
You're single, right?
It's,
you're divorced.
I am single. I am divorced. I also. Do not want any part of this. I couldn't even imagine, like, we're in the middle of having sex, and she's like, and another thing! I'm like, no. Where do you want to go eat today? I can't name a restaurant! So, I appreciate the flattery, but your best friend has just blocked you on Twitter as well, so.
Two.
There was already a. Jesus. Is it? By the way, I'm just curious. Is there anyone else whose birthday is this weekend? Anybody else have a birthday this weekend?
Yeah. Right here. Over here.
Yeah. And yet you were quiet about it the whole time. How's that possible? You didn't interrupt me once. And yet it's your turn around the sun. I don't understand. How the world, oh no, we revolve around the, okay, anyway, so, doesn't revolve around us. What do you do for a living, miss?
I'm a project manager.
You're a project manager.
Yeah.
Of what? Say that in a way that means something.
Oh God.
What do you project manage? What?
I am a project manager over our IT development over 3 to 10.
Over your IT development. Oh, no wonder. IT people usually keep to themselves. That makes sense. That makes sense. They stay quiet while you don't shut the fuck up. So. He was like, I'm managing this project. They're all like, I'm just gonna fucking code. I'm just gonna code. The code can't yell at me. Code cannot yell at me. I'll just get a quiet error message. It'll be fine. There was a guy, I don't know if he's here, the dude that's come to the shows the last couple days. Are you here by any chance? Anywhere here? Oh man, there's this one kid who's come to 3 different shows this week because he wanted to see someone heckle. Oh. And he's been so polite, he's not here today. Oh man, that's gonna be so sad. What? No, you didn't really heckle. You found the way to technically not heckle, but also kind of heckle. Like. And the thing is no one who likes my heckler videos actually cares if it's like technically a heckle. They just want to see
so
blood. You watched so many videos of me
so
do
many,
it.
He made me watch so well, many videos. So I wouldn't
well, happy it. Birthday! You're gonna be in one. So. For your birthday, I rejected you on YouTube. So anyway.
Where's Sharon? Do you think that? Like, I'm hiding her somewhere, or she owns a poke restaurant in Delray, Florida. She's doing great. Yeah, actually, I think it's technically in Boca. You don't believe that? Why the fuck? Tell me why you don't think that my sister can own a restaurant.
It was this pretty racist. Pretty Boca.
That you're pretty racist in Boca? She's Jewish. Of course, she has a restaurant in Boca. In her 40s and she's Jewish and you think What are the odds she'd be in Boca? That's ridiculous. What'd you say?
Naples.
You think she's in Naples? Have you been to Naples? Used to live there. And you think that, because I've been to Naples a bunch of times, and that's a lot more non-Jewish. You're talking the 70s. Oh, as it turns out, it's not that anymore. You lived there in the 70s, so it's like, do you know what New York City was like in the 70s? It's not the New York City that's now. If you had $4,000, you wouldn't rent an apartment for a month, you'd fucking own one in the 70s. Okay. So yes, she's in Boca. Do you want her fucking address? You want me to call her right now? Why is she trying to fact check? Do you think I'm that big of a dick that I made up an adopted black sister for my set? She's like, yeah, you know what? And is your father dead? Like, what the fuck? My act is true. I don't hear your shit. What do you do for a living, miss? I don't believe you. Anyway, so... Wait, did someone say she's a lobbyist? Oh, no wonder, she's a fucking liar. So, she's a professional liar. That's why she's like, well, he can't possibly be telling the truth. How would anyone who speaks for a living tell the truth? Kidding, what do you lobby for?
None of your business.
None of my business. Well, you're a bad lobbyist. Maybe I would have supported your cause, so.
How's the love life these days? Have we talked about this before? The way you said that, these days, like, do you know that I'm divorced? Is that why you phrased it that way? Like, how's the love life these days? Because it probably wasn't going well. Because the thing. I don't know, it's okay. It's fine. Oh, I love this. Now that he has that question, he just has his arm furly around his girl right now. Be like, I know I asked that, but I wasn't inviting him or nothing. Are you guys married?
No.
No? That sounded sad the way you said it. Like, no, I proposed a couple times, but it didn't work out. Are you dating?
Yeah, for a while now.
For a while now. Oh, I'm gonna investigate this. How long is the... By the way, you asked me about my love life. This is your fucking fault. 6 years. 6 years. And have you proposed?
No.
No? Well, if you get to 7, the state steps in, so hurry the fuck up. I don't know if you're familiar with the term common law, but, that's great. How did you guys meet?
My kid went to her school.
Your kid went to her school. She's that much younger than you? Fuck. I know I can't see well in this lighting, but I wasn't expecting that answer. They were having a play date, and I was like, I'd like to play too. So I waited till she was legal. Which took 13 years. No, I'm kidding. So she was a teacher at his school, I'm guessing?
He got in trouble, and then I went in there.
He got in trouble, and then she got in trouble. Am I right? High five! Anyway. This is all your fault for asking, so.
He said, could I ask a question? I said, I would prefer if he didn't.
Oh, just now. I thought you meant that's how he proposed. And that's why it didn't work out, because he's like, can I ask you questions? She's like, no, and put that box away. I have to graduate first.
See, most of you got that. If you're an American, you know, a kilo weighs, you're a drug dealer. Like, there's no other option.
Or you'd be a German.
What?
You'd be a German.
Or you'd be a German. If you're an American, you'd be a German? Did you hear the setup to the... I said, if you're an American, you know, a kilo weighs, you'd be a drug dealer, or you'd be a German. Also, so fucking specific. You're one of three countries that don't use the metric system. One of three. And you're like, you'd be a German, specifically. Doesn't every other country also use the metric system? Yes, but you'd clearly be a German, knowing what a kilo weighs. I don't know what the fuck is going on over there, but let's just keep it there. Are we taping this, by the way? Because if we are, let me stay on this for another second. Were you so offended to your core that I didn't specify that Germans know what kilos weigh? I just want to know what brought that out.
Your name is German, right?
My name is German. My last name is German. I'm not German, though. I don't know if you know, but back in the day, the Germans kind of went a lot of places. Took a few of us hostage and gave us some names we didn't fucking want, so...
We smoked ourselves back in time. Three more hits, this shit'll be legal. Don't laugh too loud, your mother doesn't know. Anyway, so, she knows. Oh, yeah, that makes sense, she's high right now. Anyway, so, she's been giggling the entire time. Anyway, so, what'd you say?
That's not usual for you.
That's not usual that someone is giggling?
Yeah.
No, because people laugh and applaud. See, I get what you tried to do, but you missed the mark. You were a guy who threw the dartboard and hit the fucking guy walking out of the bathroom in front of him. That's what just happened. And she just pointed at me like, yes, he does that all the time. He's the fucking worst. Wanna take another shot, Gunslinger? What's your name, man?
Tanner.
And who are you to this party?
We've been friends since middle school.
You've been friends since middle school, which is why he's sitting with his back to you. That makes perfect sense. Because he knows your shit. He's like, I've been hearing his shit since the third grade.
That's not middle school.
What?
That's
not middle school. That's all right. So middle school. So precisely what grade were you in?
Sixth grade.
Sixth. Okay. Did you not understand the joke? You're like, well, I was in sixth grade. I was not in third grade. I demand accuracy when you're mocking me.
You were probably a lot older in middle school.
I was probably a lot older in middle school. Oh, why is that? Because you're trying to say I'm not as smart as you? What do you do for a living?
What do I do for a living?
Yeah, that means work. More than me. I'm on television, motherfucker. What do you do? My mind as my job. I want to know what you do. You're in health and benefits. In health and benefits. So how many bosses do you have? That's a good question. Because I'm right.
There's a lot.
Yes, because you're not as good as you think you are. Okay. What is it? What's your position? What's your title?
What's my position?
Yes.
I'm a specialist.
You're a specialist. What is the real thing you do? When you show up at work, you don't just walk up and be like, I'm special, am I special? I understand your mother tells you that, but what do you do?
Bang on a keyboard.
You bang on a keyboard, okay. And that's why you're lashing out at others. I understand, because your job is to reload Reddit all day. That's, okay. Tanner, if that is a real name. By the way, I know I was joking that they were white before, but motherfuckers named Tanner. Holy shit. They're so white that they tried to name him darker. That's why. They're like, look at this white motherfucker. Can we call him Tanner at least? Is that? Will that help?
I'll ask my question if you want
to. You'll ask your question?
I wanted to know if you were the only ginger Jew or like...
If I was the only ginger Jew. Holy fuck, you're white, man. Jesus Christ. Holy shit, you are so white. Utah looks at you and goes, that's too white. There's a snowbank in Utah being like, that's not okay with us. Holy shit.
Hey, Steve, yeah. I got a question.
Hold on a second. Wait, I'm not done with Tanner. I'll get to your question. I actually was in the middle of my merch pitch, and Tanner was like, I gotta out-white this. Hold on. I was gonna talk about my book, but the pages aren't white enough for Tanner, so... Okay. But if that's a real question, am I the only Jewish redhead? No. Have you ever seen South Park?
Yeah.
Yeah, Kyle.
Kyle is a Jewish redhead. Do you think that he was based on magic? Or do you think that maybe there are other Jewish redheads in the world?
Kyle
2?
There's his cousin.
Oh, there was a cousin. Okay, I didn't see that particular episode. But I agree. That's next on my list. First, I gotta research middle school in South Jersey. And then I gotta watch a specific episode of South Park. I am learning so much, guys. And I have to figure out how smart you have to be to work at the bottom of health and benefits. So there's a lot of things. Someone just said, not very. You're getting heckled by the audience, man. All right.
He's pretty smart.
I appreciate that. And by the way, what I love, this is Tanner's birthday gift. This is birthday gift to you. It's not. No, not my birthday gift to him.
Okay,
I appreciate that. Don't worry about it. It's fine. I understand. Misunderstanding, it's fine. You're still smarter than him. Anyway, so. This is his birthday gift to you, because for the rest of your natural-born lives, you're going to be like, hey, remember when Tanner tried to get one over to Comedian, and he mocked him incessantly? Be like, yeah, we all remember that. You'll remind him every day. Excellent. Are you with Tanner?
I'm the girlfriend.
You're the girlfriend. No, you won't remind him every day. Eventually, you will find better. it'll be a matter of time. You're young yet. You'll figure out your standards. So, I'm sorry. I only lash out because he's so much smarter than I am. So, okay. That all said, by the way, Tanner, you're not going to want to check YouTube soon. which you'll have time at work, because that's all you do. So here's what I would say. If you want the free stuff, just sign up for my email list. That way you find out the next time I'm doing a show in Point Pleasant, which, as it turns out, is tomorrow, so hurry the fuck up. But you can sign up for the email list, but also I have some other stuff with me. I have my book. I wrote a book. It's top 5 pick on Amazon, number 1 in its category. Tanner, how's your book doing? Are you a top 5 author? You can't read. I know. Anyway, so. Someone just said that is the healthcare industry. Boom! Nicely done. Correct. Boom. Anyway, so. It's called Ginger Kid. It's a true story of getting bullied a whole lot in high school by kids like Tanner, and then growing up, finding comedy as a way out. So if you've ever felt like you don't fit in, or maybe someone in your life is going through something like that, please pick up a copy. Very relatable stories. Got a couple other things here. If you want to get one of these. So this is a t-shirt for the tour. This is for this stop on the tour. It says Point Pleasant Beach, New Jersey. It says Uncle Vinny's Comedy Club. And then all the dates of the tour, of this week of the tour anyway. So if you want to pick one of these up, commemorate tonight. Tanner, don't buy one. Anyway, so you can get one for your new boyfriend. Anyway, so. Yeah. Yes.
It's very funny. It's
Thank you.
Easy.
Thank you, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Tanner thinks it is.
Tanner, we love you, but it's not easy.
Can I just say how nice that is? That's the first time he's heard someone say that they love him in his whole life. Otherwise he wouldn't lash out like that. No, I don't think so.
I say it as much as I can.
You say it as much as you can. Holy fuck! You're getting burned all around, motherfucker! This is amazing! Birthday celebration. This was a roast for Tanner. We didn't even know. Yeah, that's the lesson. And now you've learned something too. So, okay. What's your second question though? What's your?
3 years old. Where do you see yourself in like 3 to 5 years?
Where do I see myself in 3 to 5 years?
What do you want to do?
Those are questions for them. That's not my decision. I know what you're saying. So my career has basically evolved through digital presence. I have 100 million views on YouTube and another 100 million more on Facebook. And because of it, I've gotten to do some TV and some movies, and I've gotten a tour. I've gotten to see the world on other people's dimes, which is amazing. I've been to Australia 3 times in the last 2 years. I've gotten to do stand-up in Japan and China and Mexico and South Africa. These are all countries, Tanner. I've gotten to a lot of different places. Australia's a country and a continent. And it's just been amazing. So where do I see myself in 3 to 5 years? Hopefully doing the same shit I'm doing right now, because I love doing it. So yeah, which would be great.
If you like this, subscribe to my YouTube channel here. Check out my live streams here, or you can watch more videos. If you want to check out my stuff before anybody else, check out patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. And I just announced next year's tour in over 100 cities. Save a few bucks by getting the presale tickets at stevehofstetter.com.